Meet Tia. Tia is an application developer for the Acme Corporation, and Acme are having a conference. The great thing about conferences is lots of people attend, and all of these people are potential leads for Acme. So Tia wants to make sure she can get all of their details and put them into the Acme CRM Leads app. As a mobile app developer, she creates a mobile app for all of the Acme people to use at the conference. She simply scans the contact, gets the details from the badge, but now she's got to get it into the Leads application, and Tia's not so sure about that. As a fast-moving corporation, Acme wants to know immediately when a new lead is registered. So Tia also wants, in real time, to get the data into their corporate messaging app, so that everyone knows when a new lead is scanned and new business is arriving here at Acme. Tia's not an expert in integration. She doesn't necessarily know how to connect to the Leads application or the corporate messaging, and there's going to be lots of people using this app at the conference. So it's got to be scalable, it's got to be secure. So Tia decides to solve it with IBM Cloud Pak for integration. She can simply create a secure API that's very scalable to get all the details into the Cloud Pak for integration, which can then use these pre-built flows and connectors to create the details in their CRM application and send it to the corporate messaging app. Let's follow along with Tia and see how she does it. So here's Tia in Cloud Pak for integration. She's going to use the integration designer to build her API. Tia's a smart enough technologist to know that she's already typed in all the fields she needs for her API so she can give a good demo. So in the automated assets where she saved it, she's going to go in and collect that set of fields she's already created. This creates a model in IBM Integration Designer, and you can see it's just standard fields, first name, last name, town, city, etc. She doesn't have to create an open API spec, we'll do that for her. She needs to say what she's going to do, so she wants to create a lead. But she's also going to have to create a retrieve lead operation, so she can go back and get the data when she needs it. She clicks Implement Flow, and the API stretcher is built for her. There's some test data here, and the request and response have already been set up. So the first thing Tia does is connect to her CRM system, which is Salesforce. The smart connector in CP4i knows about Salesforce and knows about leads. She simply goes in, picks the operation she wants to implement, and it goes off and gets the fields from Salesforce. Now there's a lot of these, and Tia doesn't want to map them, so she uses the IBM Smart Data Assist, which maps all the fields for her. And it knows things about city, town, postcode, and things like that. And so she simply accepts those. So that's mapped all the data that she's got, but Acme has a thing about titles. We want the full name in the title, and normally it takes a little bit of coding to do this. But with IBM Data Assist, she can just take the fields that she wants to use and teach the AI by example, just like you teach anyone else. So here the fields are going to be Mr. Andy Garrett, and Acme wants it to be Garrett in capitals, with the initial in the title here, just like this example. Tia needs to give 5 different examples to train the AI. Clicks the transform data format, and the AI Data Assist will write the code for her, as we can see here. Now, she could simply trust this and that's fine, but in IBM we have accountable AI, so she wants to test it. So she can go in and give it some test data right from the tooling. As you can see here, as Tia types the data into the sample screen data on the left, you can see that it's formatting it in real time in the tool so she can check that everything's looking good for her. She can check that the AI has built the code she wants. So now she's created the lead in Salesforce, she needs to connect to Slack, which is their messaging system. The smart connector knows about Slack, and it knows about messages and channels. So Tia selects send message. Where does she want to send it to? She wants to send it to a channel. So she picks the channel, and it goes off to Slack to find out the channel. She picks the leads channel. Now, to create the message, normally you do things like leads concatenation. But here, in the designer, she can just type away and pick the fields that she wants to make the message that she wants to say. It's really simple, and it's all prompted up, so she can make it quickly and easily, and also you can see the preview as well. So Tia's almost there. The last thing she has to do is map the lead ID that Salesforce gives her back, so she can go and get it again in the get operation, and the creation of the lead and the notification is done. Let's finish off by building the get flow, which is the retrieve data flow. So again, we use the Salesforce Smart Connector. She finds the leads and selects retrieve lead. Now, how many leads does Tia want? Well, just one. But which lead? Well, let's build that condition. She's going to default the lead ID, and we're just going to select the ID that Tia had in her API, so it's nice and easy. And it goes off to Salesforce and gets all the leads. Again, Tia can use the mapping as a smart mapper to get all the data back nice and easily to save having to map them all individually. She applies the suggestions, and she's pretty much done. So we'll hit the done button. As she typed the fields in, and that generated a fully open API data structure there with all the different paths and operations that Tia doesn't need to worry about creating manually. But here in the designer, it's also got the API gateway details, so things like rate limiting, things like JWT tokens, JWTs, security, data reaction, redaction are all built into the one editor, and it's all made nice and easy for Tia. But she wants to test it, so she clicks the green button to start it, and let's give it a go. So, with the test button, Cloud Pak for Integration generates all of the code that she would need to test it if she was going to write a test harness herself, in Python or Java or whatever her favourite language is. But at the moment, she just wants to try it out. So Tia needs to generate some test data. Oh, we can do that for her in Cloud Pak for Integration, nice and easily. You can see the data here, and she's just going to go through and check the data here, and update the title, so it just looks a bit more sensible than the generated one. So we'll click send, and send the data, and call the API. And it's come back from Salesforce. So let's just check that that's worked. We'll copy the ID that she's got back from Salesforce, and we'll go into Salesforce to see if Tia's code's worked. So she goes into leads, and she looks at the most recent leads. She'll see that Amelia Gianni is there in Salesforce, exactly as she wanted. The next thing is to check the messaging system. So Tia goes off to Slack, and this has the message in, exactly as she typed it in. So Tia's going to check the get works just for completeness. Remember, she copied the ID before, so she's going to try it here. She puts the ID straight into the generated test client, hits send, comes back, and there's all the data that she did before, but also with that title, with the transformation in there that she taught it by example before. So Tia's built her conference app. She's integrated it with a highly scalable, secure API with Cloud Pak for Integration, which automatically connected to a CRM system and to their messaging system. Well, Tia, I think you're good to go. Enjoy your conference, and I hope you get some great swag.